What up, YouTube? So it's been a while. I know I haven't uploaded. It's been like a month or a month and a half. There's a reasoning behind that, but we're not here to talk about that today. We have something special for you guys that we're going to be installing on the 350Z to get it ready for the next drift event. And yes, I am taking this thing to a drift event, but I know it's kind of random upload, but the next video's upload is going to be explaining everything that's going on in my life, like what's going on right now, why I haven't been uploading, what's to come in the future. But I took the break, but we're back, and yeah. So enough jibber-jabbing, I'll explain everything in the next video. But for now, let's go ahead and install this angle kit. So in today's video, we are going to be installing a GK Tech angle kit fully with the lower control arms and the tie rod extensions, and also some tie rod rack spacers. As you can see right here, most people, they move the location of the rack. So instead of doing that, you just put these on the tie rod ends, and it kind of moves your outer tie rods to where they would be if you did that to your rack. So this, since I'm already down there, I am going to go ahead and put these on, but let me go ahead and open these boxes and show you guys what we're working with. So as you can see, these are the lower control arms. These are the V2, so they have more adjustment to the Ackerman and stuff like that, and you can adjust them without having to take them off the car. These are the end links for the tie rod replacements. This just bolts up to where some stoppers are at. This is part of that as well. And as you can see right here, I also did get a diff brace. So this just bolts up to your diff and gives it a better place to mount, because there's, I believe, only two or one bolts holding this diff on, and it's common for these to drop right out and ruin your drive shaft, ruin your exhaust, stuff like that. So we don't want that happening. So now that I showed you what we're working with, I'm gonna go ahead and take this front bumper off so I can just jack it up from the front. Put some jack stands on and go ahead and take off these wheels so we can get ready for this install. Alright guys, so progress. We got the side skirts off, both of them over there. We got the front bumper off, it's right there. We moved the car up. It's on two blocks of wood, so I can actually slide this under. I'm gonna go ahead and jack it up a little bit, put them both on jack stands, put a chalk on there, take the wheels off, and then get ready to rock and roll. So I think I'm just gonna start with the lower control arms. I'm gonna remove them, then go ahead and do the tie rod, and then start watching the video from there, because I have no idea how to properly install these. So my girl is here, she's playing with my dog inside right now, but let's go ahead and jack this up, take the wheels off, and keep going.
All right guys, I'm under the car. As you can see, I already started taking apart the lower control arm. So I got these lower control arms are a two-piece construction, that's what you call it, but I got one pretty much loose. Now I'm working on the other one, and then hopefully these just drop right out. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to hammer them. I don't really got a lot of room under here, but we're gonna make it work.
A few moments later.
Alright guys, as you can see, it is hella dark, and I got one side in, nothing is tight, it's barely in. So I was just kind of trying to figure out how to do it, trying to understand the GK Tech video, but it's too dark to work like this. So it's currently like 8:30. I got to work at like 5:30, so I didn't have much time to work on it. I'm going to leave this like this, go ahead and finish up tomorrow morning, get with you guys, and then we'll just go from there. It's time to go take a shower, go to sleep, and get ready for tomorrow.
Damn.
We're back in the daytime. As you can see in the back, we got my dad hammering and wrenching. Yesterday, we left off over here. Hold up, bye. We got this lower control arm on, everything's on, nothing's tight yet. We just went ahead and took off the inner tie rod so I can go ahead and put this rack spacers on to give us some more thread engagement and prevent us from binding up. But as you can see on this side, we got this other part of the lower control arm off. We got the other one over there. I had to take the little cone piece off. And right now what we're dealing with is that part of the bushing for the lower control arm. It's being a little pain in the butt, but it's coming off. It's slowly. And yep. Toma. He just hit his
banger.
Head on the fender. Banger. But yeah, guys, we're gonna keep rocking and rolling. And yeah. See you guys when I get another update. Okay, guys. Don't mind that noise in the background. They're doing some construction over there. But I am going to AutoZone to pick up an Allen wrench for this because the one I have is at work. And yeah. And then, as you can see right here, we got everything all kind of set up. None of the arms are in on this side. But we're going to start with this right here. Go get that. And then we'll start buttoning everything up. So let's go get that. And we'll be back. All right, guys. So we got both sides in. We got most of it's tight except the tie rods. But if you hear the wind, my bad. But I got it fully locked. I made sure my wheels don't hit anything or anything. And let me show you guys what we got going on. Woo! Oh my goodness. Look at that angle, baby. Look at it. That is a lot of angle. As you guys can see right here, I know I need new ball joints. But we got everything tidied up. Let me go ahead, see if I can move it this way. Oh, wrong way. As you guys can see right here, we got, oops, let it focus. We got the whole contraption going on. Make sure everything's tight. As you guys can see, you can't really use the old bolts, but we just cut a little piece and we have them there. For now, I didn't adjust any of this because I want to make them even. And then after I make them even, I'm going to go ahead and use my toe plates to then go ahead and adjust the toe to make it at least drivable to go to get alignment. I might end up putting on the trailer and get alignment at a special thrift shop near New Jersey or something like that. But yeah, guys, as you can see, we're ready to go. So we're gonna go ahead and tighten everything, put everything back on the floor, and then show you guys from there. All right, guys, so as you can see, we are putting the wheels back on. I did raise the car a little bit in the front. I know this angle is gonna give it a little bit more camber, so with raising it, I'm hoping I can put some spacers on, maybe poke it out a little bit more. If not, I'll just adjust the camber to give it a little less. But I'm gonna go ahead and drop it on some blocks to see how the fitment is, and then go ahead and eyeball the alignment so it's at least drivable for right now. As you can see, this is what it looks like. It looks crazy under here, man. Really looks good. Thanks to my girlfriend. If you guys didn't know, this was a birthday present by my girlfriend, so. Damn. There you go. Everything's all good, tighten up. So we're gonna go ahead and drop there, adjust those tie rod ends, and then see where we're at from there. Alright guys, so we're inside right now. This is the next segment of this video, getting my 350Z ready for the next drift event. As you guys can see right here, I got a list of things to do. I gotta set up the truck for the trailer. I gotta put the diff brace on, the GK Tech diff brace, do a diff flush because I haven't done it ever since I wore the diff, which is really bad. Gotta change the oil, put an extra half quart in there of 10W40. And then I want to go ahead and get my car aligned, make sure the rear camber is at zero so I have even tire wear and I don't waste any tires. And then I got to mount and balance some tires that I'm taking out to the drift event, and of course pack up the truck and stuff like that. So right now I'm going to go ahead to AutoZone, pick up that diff fluid, also go ahead and pick up some oil to put in the car, and I also got to return this tool right here, which is what I actually used to take off the inner tie rods, which this just slides in and you put this around the tie rod and boom boom, comes off loose. I had to rent this for $90. If you guys didn't know, AutoZone rents a lot of tools, so if you're in a pinch and you see a tool you see on YouTube that they say they bought whatever and it kind of looks like a specialty tool, like it's just for that, more than likely is that AutoZone rents it. So right now I just paid $90 for that, bring it back, they're gonna give me my money back, and that's a done deal. So I'm gonna go ahead over there, grab something to eat, come back, lift up my car, start working on that, and then yeah, we'll go from there. She is about to get in with a cold start. And guys, I know you guys see the trailer in the background. I didn't want to talk about it in this video, and I'm not gonna talk about it in this video. That's why you gotta come next video. Like I said, there's a lot of things.
A lot of things. I gotta update on you.
Cause as you guys can see, something's missing, right? and I'm drifting this car. I just put an angle kit on this car. I don't know, if you put two and two together, you probably know what's going on, but let's go. Let's give you guys a little cold start. My car is honestly not that loud, but it does have exhaust leaks, so. Makes it a little louder. Alright, let's go ahead and let this thing warm up, and then we're going to head out to AutoZone. I just wanted to get out the car real quick and show you guys how much angle this thing actually has. And it's pretty insane, man. It's so good. It's so good. So also in today's video, I didn't tell you guys, I'm going to be taking off the body kit and changing the wheels so I can actually be aligning it on my job so it fits on the alignment rack and stuff so it doesn't give me a hard time. And then I'll be coming back and then throwing everything back on for the drift event. So, yep, I got everything in the car. Let's go ahead and get over to AutoZone so we can return the stuff and get back and start working. Yeah, so we ended up only getting out with this because they didn't have what I needed. I might be needing more than this, but it's a welded diff, so it doesn't really matter. I'm going to just end up leaving some of the fluid in there. I had to be quick because I was parked in an illegal spot. It looks sick, though. Whoops, oh, forgot you guys. I seen him somewhere. Oh, look at him. What up, little guy? How you doing? I didn't mean to scare you last time. You like my car? Come here. Oh my god, he's running. No, come here. You know what, get away. Anyways, as you guys can see, I do have the kit off. My boy over here, he was helping me. Shout out to the cat. It's just two screws on this side, two screws on that side, some zip ties, four screws in the front, and one screw on this side because the other side was broken. I just had some tape holding it up. But as you guys can see, the whole kit is off. I have to do this because the alignment rack at my job is like the one you have to drive on. And with my kit, I cannot get on it whatsoever. One second, let me put my wind mic on just to make sure you guys aren't listening to this wind. But yeah, like I was saying, it's not an in-ground one. You actually have to drive onto it. So this is gonna help me out. And they have the ones that, the alignment things that you have to clamp around the wheel. So I'm gonna change these wheels, cause since these are deep dish, when it clamps around the wheel, it won't sit where it's supposed to be. So I'm just gonna put my dad's RX-8 wheels on there cause they're the same look pattern. And then get alignment, zero out the camera in the rear. Also go ahead and fix the toe up front, make sure all that is good, and then bring it back, put everything back, and yeah, should be good. Guys, take a load of this. So I went ahead and installed it and everything. There's a factory hole in the subframe right here, random. You just stick this through there. There's a nut on the other side that's really hard to get to. You put the brackets in, take these two bolts out, bolt that in. I had to take this off again because I forgot the washer, whatever. I'm just using a regular ratchet, so it took me a while. And I go to drain the diff fluid and the fill plug is covered by the brace, man. So I gotta take this whole thing apart again. What a day. My luck is amazing, right? Gotta take all this apart. Anyways, let's go ahead and see what this fluid looks like. Look at that. Look at those chunks. Big chunk of metal there. Alright guys, so we went ahead and finished everything in the rear, changed the diff fluid, everything's all tight and good. Right now I just took off these two wheels. Since I have it off already, I am going to go ahead and adjust the e-brake. So it's like right about to touch, so right when I pull the e-brake, it engages and it gives me better handbrake, because I am going to be using the stock handbrake for this event. So all you gotta do is put this handbrake down, go ahead and spin this. You should be able to spin it with your hand until you see the little gears there, and just keep adjusting it until it gets hard to turn, and then go two clicks back and then you should be good like that. So we're gonna do that for both sides, then grab the two Mazda wheels that are over there. You can see them over there. Put these in the rear, jack up the front, put the other two Mazda wheels in the front, and then we should be good to go get in line. All right guys, so as you can see, we're all done. I went around the parking lot, not the parking lot, but the block, and made sure they locked up, and they locked up perfectly right away, right when I pulled the e-brake, just how I want it. And just doing that around the block on the corners and stuff, man, I can't wait to start drifting this thing. I'm so excited. So stay tuned for the next video. I think I'm about to go to a car meet, so I'll probably end the video over there. I don't know if I'm gonna vlog it, but yeah, that's later today. But you guys can see, it's all good. So see you in the next clip. Alright y'all, we had a little car meet. I got my shit parked up with the angle kit all out. My girl, you know, she's my model. She's standing next to the car. We got some Burger King. About to give y'all a quick rundown of the car meet. People are already starting to leave. I've been here for like 30 minutes now. Yasiel was here, he had to leave because he had some things he needs to handle, you know what I'm saying? But we're about to get going. You wanna come with me? Come on, y'all, walk fast. So right here we got WRX right there. Supra with a BMW badge. I don't know why. We got this, whatever that is. We got whatever that is. We got this RS right here. Nice looking color. Over here is a F30. Or I said F30. F80 M3. We got this drag pack, whatever that is. This thing right here, what a beauty. Beautiful. I know y'all can't see anything, but super tough. We got whatever that is. We got these crazy guys over here. Oh my goodness. This is right here. Shout out to Yavi. You probably know what that is, but I don't. I'm not a car guy. You guys can see we got a lineup over here. Pretty regular car meet, but we had nothing else to do, so we came. And you already know the vibes. Look at that truck. I want one like that. What is that, F-250? Nice. Nice. A little teaser, this is gonna be me soon. Yo, imagine me hopping out of this, man. What the fuck? Nah, that's rich people. I don't got that money. Something similar at all. I'll let her drive it too. What?
Stay tuned.
But yeah guys, we're here at the meet. I don't know if I told you I was coming to a meet, but the angle kit feels great. 10 out of 10. What's wise fab? GK Tech.
Let's
all day,
do
baby.
A mukbang.
It's cheaper. But we can do a mukbang real quick. I got this burger right here.
Burger?
About to try it. Yeah, this chicken sandwich. Try it. Thanks for the lighting. Oh my god. This, they advertise it so big, it's so small. What is this?
Bacon, lettuce on
top. I did wash my car too. For the first time in forever, I never do that.
Trash. It's salty.
How you know? This is salty as fuck, man. Don't eat Burger King. Go to McDonald's. I'll tell your girl to make you a chicken sandwich.
I made a chicken sandwich, right?
Yep.
You didn't like it. But he doesn't guys, like my food, guys.
But yeah, guys, that's pretty much going to end today's video.
That's it?
I know it was short. Or I don't know if it was short. Actually, I don't know yet. But stay tuned for the next video. It's probably going to be a drift video. If it's not a drift video, it's a rundown on why I haven't been uploading and stuff like that. There's a lot of updates I got to put you guys on to. But I appreciate you guys staying to the end. Shout out to all my new subscribers, and go follow me on Instagram, HYPPEERR. And yeah, stay tuned for my next video. See you, drift event coming soon.
peace on the street, son. I can't even lie, you ain't my type, you ain't even all that fine in person. I can guarantee you if you my kind, she got every bag you can imagine. Big house, I can really be bragging. 100,000 in my mouth like what's happening. Not the big cheap tea, that's embarrassing. He ain't me, you can keep the comparison. My bitch, probably one of the baddest. Good girl, turning into a